Good morning, students. Now we'll learn about the concept of Pirani gauge, which is used for measuring the value of pressure. So already we have learned about the concept of Wheatstone bridge. Here also we are using the concept of Wheatstone bridge itself. So here this is a diagrammatical representation of Pirani gauge consisting of four arms having resistance A, B, C and D, where B is called as adjustable arm or adjustable rheostat, and these two ends are connected with the power supply. So initially let us consider this A filament is not having any sort of chamber. Let us consider this is having no chamber. So under initial conditions, whenever you are supplying some current, what happens? The current starts flowing in the circuit in such a way that galvanometer shows some deflection. So in order to make the bridge under balanced condition, what we have to do? The adjustable arm, this resistance, B resistance, has to be changed in such a way that the current should show zero deflection, that is I equals to zero. Under such conditions, the bridge is said to be balanced. So that is how to make the bridge as balanced condition. Now let us come to Pirani gauge. So let us take the Wheatstone bridge having four arms or four filaments connected at these ends A, B, C and D. These all elements are made up of with platinum material because they are non-reactive to any other losses. So let us consider this is an arm whose pressure has to be measured is connected with a chamber over here, having some inlet. From this inlet, the gas, whatever it is, has to be sent, can be sent into this chamber, and that pressure can be found out over here. So what is happening? We are giving some power supply and we are sending the gas, whatever the value has to be measured, we are sending the gas through this inlet, that is termed as PR. So under bridge balanced condition, we know the condition as A by B equals to C by D. So now what is happening? The pressure of the gas, whatever it is to be measured, is sent into this chamber. By connecting a chamber, the pressure of the gas, whatever to be measured, is given to this chamber. So what is happening now? The A resistance is becoming as unknown value. So from this condition, what we can write? A equals to C by D into B. Now we can find out the value of A. That gives you the value of resistance. So this resistance value, whatever we are getting, that is tabulated by using some calibrated scale in such a way that if resistance value is showing some value of 10 ohms, then its equivalent pressure value is written over that calibrated scale. In this way, we can find out the value of unknown pressure. So here the gas, whatever we are sending, we are finding out the pressure of that particular gas by make use of Wheatstone bridge. So this is what here you can see. Initially, no gas is supplied under normal atmospheric condition. Now adjust the rheostat B so that the galvanometer shows zero deflection, that is null deflection. At that condition, the bridge is said to be balanced, that is A by B equals to C by D. Now supply the power and also connect the chamber across a platinum filament and supply gas whose pressure is to be found because of this value of gets changed, that is A equals to C by D into B. From this value, you can find out the A value, which automatically gives you the value of pressure. The resistance is getting changed, that is nothing but calibrated resistor gives you the pressure whatever to be measured. We already learnt about thermal conductivity, that if higher pressure or higher density, then resistance is low. If you are sending lower pressure gas or lower density gas, then the resistance value is high. This is how the Pirani gauge works.